So in our last video, we touched a little bit on searching for content up top, and we're actually going to go into this a little bit more in detail in this video. And also, we're going to explore different ways that we can actually organize our data. Let's start by searching for the term caulking up on the search bar. And we can see that we get 38 results when this pulls up. On my left side here, by selecting this tag tool right here, I get options called 6W tags. These are filters. So I can actually filter the search that comes up by a variety of different types of filters. We can customize these filters, and we'll get into that in a little bit more detail at a later time. But for now, let's just go ahead and search by physical product, for example, just to see what it looks like. And when I do this, my results now only show actual physical models, and they're actually giving me the results that I want now. So this is actually the result I'm looking for. So that's perfect. But if we wanted to get more custom with it, we totally can. To do this, I'm going to use the app called 3DEXPERIENCE. 3DEXPERIENCE is the app where we store all of our models. So we don't necessarily need to worry about that right now because we're going to cover it in a later video. But all you need to know is if I click, for example, say on the caulking gun final assembly that we had created, and we want to add a custom tag to this, we just click on this, click on the 6W tags button, and we see that we have an option to create a custom tag. These tags can be who, when, what, where, why, and how, and that's where 6W comes from. And we'll just pretend that how begins with a W. In this particular case, we have what selected, and that works perfectly for us. We'll enter the tag name, semester project. So as you can see, semester project's already a tag that I made previously, but all we'd have to do if we wanted to create a new one would just be type semester project, then add the tag. So semester project is something that we can search this by. So let's go ahead and take a look at what that looks like. So I can come back into xDesign, and we can say that we want to start another search. We can start by searching caulking again, and let's see how much easier it is now that I can just search by this custom tag. The model that we want comes right up, and it's filtered down from 38 results down to 1, just like that. And this is really good if you ever want to create a custom project and you want to tag it with the name of the project. So the last thing that we want to talk about in this video is how to actually use Anovia Bookmarks Editor and what that is and what it's good for. So let's say that I use this model a lot and I actually don't even want to search for it every single time. I want to just save a place where I know it's going to be at all times. That's exactly what Anovia Bookmarks Editor is. So I'm going to open up Anovia Bookmarks Editor. It can be dragged in just like any other app. And we can see that I have semester project starting model. And this is just basically a folder. I can create a new bookmark by right-clicking, and then we get the option to create a new bookmark. In this particular case, this semester project starting model has no models in it right now. We can add models by either clicking add existing. We can upload a file from our desktop, or the easiest way to do it is to go into our lifecycle tab, click on this little compass right here, and right away we see the revision actually pop up, and we can drag this right into our bookmark. We can see that this is successfully done, and if we wanted to test this out, what we could do is actually just go ahead and refresh our xDesign widget. So that way it'll open us back up to the home screen. And now that we've added this Anovia Bookmarks Editor, we can actually go in, drag this model right into xDesign. And you can see it opens up right where we left off. So we've covered a lot in this video. Let's recap what we just did cover. So we first began our discussion by exploring different ways to search and organizing data using 3D search and 6W tags. Then we also took a look at AnoviaWorks Bookmark Editor, how to add a custom bookmark, and access your data with an easier way to do it. So stick around for our next video where we will expand a little bit more on this.